each human body is made of 5 elements. Each human body or life needs 5 elements. Outside breath, inside prana. Outside breath, inside prana. And outside breath is going in and coming out. It is affecting the pranas inside. There are 108 pranas in the body. 108 pranas in the body, out of which 5 principal pranas, prana, apana, etc. and 5 lower pranas. So, Krukara, Dhananjaya, etc. In the body, there are pranic channels. Physically, the breath goes from nose to the lung, from lung to the nose and out. If you analyze breath, it goes from nose to lung, lung to heart, and heart to lung, lung to out. Again, if you analyze, breath is going from nose to lung, lung to heart, heart to every cell of the body through arteries, and again from every cell of the body through the vein to the heart, from heart to the lung and out. So if you go on analyzing, this breath is going from gross to subtle to subtler and subtlest. In this way, the pranic flow in the body is through pranic channels. How many pranic channels are there in the body? 727,210,102, I think, the number. This many pranic channels in the body, out of which 3 principal pranic channels, Ida, Pingala and Sushumna. Then there are minor pranic channels, Chitra, Vajra, Kurma and so on. Each pranic channel has their own function. Ida has its function, Pingala has its function. And to activate these pranic channels, the breath is the means. So, to, as he asked about the Kurma Nadi, so there are all these nadis, they are regulating our life. Meditate a little, slowly you will know more. These are all technical things. However, human life is a special gift. We don't know tomorrow, but we know today. Today is not 24 hours. Today means now. One who wants to be in peace should be peace now, otherwise never. People say peace is our birthright, just like people say freedom is our birthright. I read somewhere in the license plate it was written, be free or die, or something it was written.
I think Delaware state has that, be free or die.
In some state, be free or die. However, come here. So, freedom is our birthright. This freedom is not to live like animals. Remember, animals have freedom. In human life, there is some discipline. How to sit, how to speak, how to look, how to move. How to drive your car, there is discipline. Last night we had flat tire. And John Baba told something wrong in the so he got out of the car and took the car to the shoulder, you know. And luckily we had another following car of the disciple. So he came to tell the disciple to take us so that he can fix the car and come a little later. Immediately police van. Not only one police van, one after the other two. And we became VIPs. One in the front, one in the back. In the middle, we two, we went to the gas station from where he said, in the highway, it is not safe to do like this. Come, it's nearby. So, freedom doesn't mean, do you understand me? I am free to do anything. It is animal's life. Human life is a disciplined life. And just like freedom is our birthright, the real freedom is getting free from the dictatorial rule of the mind and the senses, to be disciplined. Peace is our birthright. It is not peace is our birthright, peace is our nature. Unfortunately, we forget it. You will say, how do you tell peace is our nature? I will give an example. Every day, when you go to bed and sleep, suppose you are sleeping, you are not having my sleep. You are supposed sleeping for 5-6 hours. At that time, how do you sleep? Are you not in peace during sleep? What happens during your sleep? Do you remember your family? No. Job? No. Anxiety? No. Tension? No. Fear? No. Wife? No. Husband? No. Wife and husband sleeping on the same bed, you forget everybody. You are in peace. Peace is our nature. Unfortunately, leading unnatural life of tension, anxiety, fear, worries, emotion, irresistible desires, anger, ego, pride, we lose our, you know, it is covered up. Today one person came and he told, young man, he told his father is not well and undergoing treatment, and he told, we had a very difficult relationship. Father was, you know, he was a military man. And because now he's having health problem, when he was talking to the father, father started crying. And the son was telling, if this would have happened 30 years before, it would have been nice. Now he has changed a lot. Purpose of telling this, he had this love within, but it was like, you know, military discipline. And it was covered with, up with a big stone. That is happening to us. Our peace, our love, our joy in life is covered up with this imaginary fear, anxiety, tension, and so on. We have to live in our true nature. Nature is peace, nature is love, nature is smile. To smile, I will give an example. It is easy to smile or easy to shout? Why? Because it is natural. And to shout or scream, it needs lots of preparation. Cultivate anger, cultivate anger, cultivate anger. Then so, we are going away from our natural life. So, few simple things I will tell. Live a joyful life. Nobody is stealing your joy. Joy is your treasure, peace, happiness is your treasure. Don't live only for yourself, live for others. Modern life is very self-centered, egocentric, personalized life. But we have to live for others, smile, be with others, help others wherever it is possible and wherever it is needed. Care for others. Life will be more, life is to give. If you look at a plant, suppose this plant, I don't like, you know, too many flowers to be cut. But in West, it is, flower has a business. And yesterday when I was guiding meditation, and I told my eyes move. So, I saw beautiful florist shop and so many flowers through the window. It looks so beautiful. A tiny plant is giving. Whenever you take little honey, from where this honey comes? Who collects honey? Bee. From how many flowers it collects honey? You just imagine. One bee flying nearly 5 kilometers, 3-4 miles every day, collecting honey, coming back, going and coming, and everybody is giving. If we learn the life, how to give love to your wife, give love to your husband, give love to your friends, give love to the parents, like loving each other makes life much easier. Every day, little prayer and meditation. Do it every day. If you chant the name of God, if any spiritual practice, do it, but do it every day.